Welcome back, everybody. Gaming for XP, we're going to turn these into this today. Let's get building. G'day, everybody. Welcome to Outpost Jumanja. I hope that's right pronunciation. If it isn't, I can't help it. So I had an idea for a tower defense that I've been thinking for a while, so I thought I would have an attempt at building it. Certainly where my idea starts and where it finishes are polar opposites, but I thought this was really worth sharing because I think what I end up with is really good. I like it a lot, and I think it'd be useful for a lot of people when they're building their settlement defences. So I don't know if you've been up this far north. This settlement is a long, long way. It's all pretty much almost at the very edge of the map, right up in the north. Probably directly north almost. North to northeast, I guess. Corner of the map. And you basically get a quest, I think from 10 Pines Bluff, to come and clear this place out. And it's only a small settlement, but it certainly is a little bit fiddly as far as the terrain goes and the way that the border of the settlement is actually set up. So I have built here before. I've really enjoyed building here in the past, and so it just made sense this is where I'd build today. So you can see I've used the prefabs just to get a structure in place. And now I'm starting to work at first kind of protocol was to try and figure out how we're going to get from the bottom floor to the top floor, so hence why I'm playing with stairs. You will see that this will glitch a little bit through the floor, but this is the best set of stairs or ladders I could find. So in the final build, you don't really see it that much. You don't really notice it. So that's all good. So I'll get the first set of stairs in. We'll now get the second set in, and then we'll start building around that. So very simple structure and very simple way. Really just getting quickly to the overall look of it. Now, my initial idea was to build a big tower here. It ends up like a defensive wall or an entranceway, but sometimes you just come up with these ideas and just let them go and see where they take you. So I do have a little bit of problems getting this ladder in, and in actual fact I have to come up with a different solution to get it to snap in there, and you will see that fairly shortly what I end up doing. I'm just trying all different floors to get it to snap. I end up taking things off because for some reason it won't snap in, and it's the perfect height, so it does clip through the floor a little bit, which is fine, but I don't mind that. A lot of the time, again with the build order, you've seen that clip into the right hand side there. For some reason this would not, see I'm taking things off to see if it, that, for some reason it would not clip to that side. So, after a lot of struggle and heartache, I end up, see it'll clip there. Okay, fine. Now I have to take the ladder off, put the foundation back, and then put the ladder back in. There we go, fantastic. Now, what now happens is something quite funny, because it is quite by mistake. Yep, put that in there. Come on, push it in. Yep, there we go, beautiful. Quite by mistake, the solution just appears in front of me, and you'll see what I'm talking about in a second. So up we go. Oh. And around we go, up, right to the top, and I like to always do this to see if the flow. Now I turn the corner and go, oh, the ladders could possibly be on that side. What a good idea. Why didn't I think of that? So that's where we end up putting it. Just because the way the flow works and how you would actually use a ladder. So you would go up, round the corner, up again, and we're good. Here we go, beautiful. All good. Sorted. So that's the major part of the kind of figuring out the complicated part over and done with. So from here on in, it should be a fairly straightforward kind of build. Oh, look, a floating tower. Obviously, we'll put some supports in there a little bit later, and it won't be floating. So it's actually a good idea if you wanted to just put a defensive tower in. Now, you're restricted there by putting another piece of flooring above the stairs, otherwise you can't get up. So I like to build this away from the wall and then move it around. Now, okay, so just give me some room. If you build too close to the edge of the settlement, it does make life just a fraction more difficult. And it doesn't give you any room to build. And you know, when you're in tight, if you've ever built in tight spaces with all that, you know it can be extremely tricky and it can take a lot longer. So these scrap walls I love. Been watching a few people using them lately. And they actually, because I put them up on the foundations, they line up perfectly with the top. Look at that. Click on, do the anti-shimmering trick and go and get the next one. And so you will get some build music in this video because there's a lot of repetitive stuff and I really don't want to have you watching half an hour of me doing the same thing, just building the wall. But for now, I'll just show you how to do the basics and then we'll get some music happening. So you can see these fences aren't quite wide enough to cover the length of that. If you look at the, so I'm just checking it's all nice and tight and it's all locked in. If you look on the right hand side there, it's not quite wide enough, too wide. So something just to keep an eye out for, that you'll need to come up with a solution there. And in fact, this does cause me other issues later on, which I managed to figure out. But because I've put those supports inside, that bush is annoying me because I can't see things. Probably get rid of that in a sec. Get rid of it. And if you're scrapping those bushes, you sometimes have to, as I did there, walk away from them a fair distance before they'll actually activate. So, wanted to keep this going because I make a mistake here and it's important that you see that. See how that fencing is curved at the top part? Don't use those because it will cause you problems. Use the ones that are straight, and I will scrap this in a second, but make sure you use the ones that are straight. It'll save you a lot of anguish. So I'll get rid of that. Don't like that one. But this is all the track, this is all, see it, there we go, that's a straight one. And here we go. We're going to speed this up a little bit. So you see, I'm just trying to get this as tight as possible in on that side of the structure so that the gap's minimal. So why don't we give you some building music and I'll come back and talk to you shortly. Welcome back, and you can see that during that building session, I actually built one half and then moved it over, selected all, and now I'm making the second half. It's an easier way of doing it, just get everything in place, just what I was talking to you about, and especially because the structure is quite tight against both the settlement boundaries here, so it's easier to build one half, move it into place, and then build the second up. And so you can see that the main structure is really starting to come together nicely here. I know it's a bit of a rinse and repeat, but you can see I'm glitching these walls in just so they're level and right on the edge there. And the great thing about these pieces is you can use some of those lines and those pieces sticking out the top as references. So let's just walk up the top here. Yeah, and you can see I have a bit of an issue there getting up the stairs, and I need to actually end up taking a wall piece out and replacing one of those flat ones, because those supports are sticking through and stop me walking through. So a little bit of a window here, we're going to use this, there we go, use that for a window, and we'll put a bit down the bottom like that. And I wanted to keep it the look very scrappy. If you look around here, if you come up this far north, have a look around the area before you come in, and you'll see what I mean. There's lots of little shacks around, and you know, it's pretty remote, so I wanted to keep that vibe. So those gaps in the walls, that side, I'm just going to plug up with these window boards. Fantastic for all kinds of things. And I use them a lot in this build. Just to plug up gaps like that. And I think it actually helps the look. It does help the overall look of everything looking as though it's just been kind of thrown together for whatever they could find. These boards are a little bit tricky, but just persist. You see there, I just persisted with that one, and it went in eventually. Sometimes you just have to fiddle around with different ones. Eventually something will fit. See? Or you can use those. Just look as though they've nailed a couple of boards on. There we go. Fantastic. That works. So really, as you can see, I was going to build a big, tall, defensive tower, and that's really not what has happened. We'll just move these floors up a bit. It's become something quite different. Evolved into something quite different. So, it's all good. I'm liking the look of this. I like where it's going. And that barbed wire on the walls that I put in the front are just the right height for some reason, which I like. And what suddenly occurs to me here is that I could actually make this into an entranceway. So I look at that and I kind of say, well, there's a room, the potential space I could use there, and then suddenly this entranceway appears in front of me. And I, you know, this is just what happens when you're building. Sometimes you just come up with ideas. There you go. And there we go. So now we've got two rooms on the bottom. The one there, which I put a door on. See, I put that on and go, hang on, there's a room there. Why would I do that? Put a door on. There we go. That'll do. I don't know why they want to jump up like that, but never mind. And then there's a potential room on the left-hand side. We're looking straight at it right now. So, and if you've watched my videos before, you like it. You know I like these kind of multiple level and multiple room places. So, and I like, I've left the foundations fairly low, so the grass comes through the wood, and I think that actually helps to sell the overall look that I'm going for. Now here, for some reason, and I do fix it up, but I don't know why, there's some weird snappage going on here. I don't know if snappage is a word. If it isn't, it should be. but they're actually floating for some reason, and I've snapped them on those upper floor pieces, but they're actually sitting a little bit off the ground. I do fix it, but I don't know why. It's just one of those weird, strange things that happen sometimes. Okay, in we go. We're going to have to persuade you into here. Just take your time when you're doing this kind of stuff and just make sure. Sometimes it's better to go back and take that piece so that you've got a better view, so that you can step back. Sometimes the problem is if you grab building materials too close, you're too close to it when you're building and you can't actually see where to fit it and whether it fits properly. So I'll pull that down because that was too high. And I think I'll notice in a minute that these are all floating. Hang on. Just to say, how is that floating? Just pull that down. There we go. That one should just click in. Okay, so that's okay. That's all good. Yeah, so that's very strange. I think it's just the wall pieces because it is a different mod. It is from vanilla extensions, whereas the floors are just what's in the normal game. These pieces are great. I'm starting to use them a fair bit, these ramps. I don't know why they weren't in the original game, Bethesda. They should have been. And there we go. We've got an entranceway into the outpost. That makes sense. And we have a window happening here. Quite a good look there. Probably need to put a floor up there. And really, if you look at this, or you could put a prefab if you wanted. If you look at this outpost and you actually look down there to the right there, and what is here, there's lots of sheet metal. There's lots of chain link fences, barbed wire and concrete and wood. So that's basically what I've went with. If you know the main area where the workshop is, the little sleeping area above there is very scrappy. So I've used that as a kind of starting point and tried to keep the whole settlement in that kind of overall look and just expand on it. So this is actually been a good build up. For some reason there are just some settlements in Fallout that you'll just fall in love with, and every time you come and build here you'll just love building here, and this for me is one of those places. So the story of this build is I had an idea. I wanted to build a tower. I came and liberated the outpost in Zamunda just so I could do a demonstration build. And yeah, a lot of hours later, probably about 40 hours later, I've just completed yesterday the entire settlement. So yeah, it happens, people. I have recorded a lot of that. Whether I actually put it on the channel, I'm not sure. If you'd like to see it, let me know. I'm happy to upload some of those vids for you. I certainly will be doing a couple because there's some quite crazy ideas that I come up with for some buildings and some various pieces that I do. I'm not going to tell you too much. And so I will upload at least one or two of those. But yeah, it took a long time to build this. So for some reason, again, weird snapping. Not going to happen there, don't know why. Everything just doesn't want its fit there. So I end up making that another balcony stroke window. Why not? So we're really on the downhill slope now. We're just putting, defining the areas of the guard tower. And then, it's just a case of decorating it up. But, it is a pretty simple build, you know me. I like to make things reasonably simple to build. I have done some overcomplicated builds, and I think after you've been building for quite a while, you get to the point where you say, no, things need to be as simple as we can make them, but you don't want to compromise the look either. So, you know, this is all come from basically a very simple idea, and I've just continued to build, for want of a better word, build on the idea and add bits and take bits away. And in the end, when I watch this back, it's not a complicated build at all. So I'm just gonna put a little balcony piece in here, little railing in there, bang. You got like a little outlook window, whatever you want to call it. Okay. Probably just last thing we'll do is probably going to put my favourite bit of chain link fence on the window there. In you go. And we're pretty much done, I think. So here's the tour. After I've taking a little bit of time to decorate it up. You can see there's a heap of some walls that come with vanilla extensions that actually have these barrels and various things on them. So you can see that at the front. You can see the sides look pretty uniform. I've added a little defensive tower up the top there. And then just used sandbags and barrels and boxes and all kinds of things just to dress up the entranceway a little bit. Not too much has changed at the back. There's some scrappy items lying around. A little bit of a office in the right hand side here. Pretty basic. Little storeroom on the left. Lots of ammunition, lots of dynamite, etc. Some food stores, of course. There's lots of alcohol. It's a lonely life in the remote outposts. Lots of ammunition and armor. And what you'll see in this build, once you see the final settlement, is there's so many little details that I've added. So I thought underneath here could be a bunk room or just somewhere where the guards would get their head down and be able to have a sleep. And I've kept it very, very minimal. I want to give the impression of a very remote outpost. So these guys haven't got a lot. They couldn't carry a lot from somewhere like Diamond City or Sanctuary, anywhere like that, because it's such a long way. And then we'll go up top. And I've expanded the top area. Put some turrets in. Of course, they're on boxes and they've got their own little candles. But you can see it's a great, from up here, fantastic outlook across the region. Push this little guard post there so you've got an even better viewpoint, just a fraction higher. And then just a little chill area here. So I hope you enjoyed this build. It was a lot of fun. Not what I expected it would end up as, but I am really, really pleased how it did end up. And it inspired me to do a bigger build. So thanks for watching. Catch you later, guys.